Welcome back to the Island54 Devlog. I got some feedback that the graphics in my game looked a bit like it had fallen out of the ugly tree and hit every branch on the way down. Today, I invite you to join me as I give my game world a makeover. In previous episodes, I've talked about how I'm going to focus on prototyping my crafting survival game. I've wanted to avoid going off on tangents that aren't helping me either learn technical aspects of Unity or teach me how my own game will work. But over the weekend, I went off on a dreaded tangent. I'll show you the process I followed to pretty up my world, including my failed attempts. I'm not sure what I want my game to look like during development. It's definitely going to be too much work to build and maintain something photorealistic like a lot of AAA games, but I don't want it to look like Minecraft either. I think something inspired by the island in my title animation would be nice, but I didn't know exactly what I was after. My first attempt was to use Unity's terrain system. I replaced my ground plane with a terrain object and quickly threw together a script to apply Perlin noise to it. I added a pastel green as the material and tried it out. While I was happy with the undulation of the terrain, it just didn't feel right. It didn't scream Island 54. I figured it was beyond redemption, so I threw it away. Next, I went off on a tangent to my tangent and built a basic chunk and voxel system. It's pretty bare bones. A chunk just stores a three-dimensional array of blocks, which themselves are either solid or air. I did have an ulterior motive for implementing voxels, which I'll be covering in an upcoming episode. I wrote a renderer that converts the chunk to a mesh. Again, it's pretty simple. For each block, it renders each of its faces, if and only if there is no solid block in that direction. I gave it a try and was pretty unimpressed. I immediately saw two problems. It looked like budget Minecraft, and it was also too flat. All the grass faces point the same way. It's nothing like the island at the start. I still wanted to work with voxels though, so I decided to iterate. I changed the rendering code to shift the top vertices of each voxel up or down, depending on the blocks around it. I also duplicated all the vertices so that each face could define its own normal, preventing the render pipeline from blending the normals and giving it a more faceted look. This was looking more promising. I put a limit on the slope of the terrain so that as the terrain generation gets more extreme, cliffs are able to form. Now, some gaps also appear in the mesh, but I can fix those later. Now I just needed some finishing touches. I added a sand material that gets applied below Y10, and a water plane, which required a quick upgrade of the rendering pipeline to URP. And the end result is something I'm quite proud of. Now, if you enjoyed this episode and want to support the series, please do leave a thumbs up, it really does help. And until next time, happy game developing.